First aid can be especially important to know when you're staying active. The quick actions of a friend actually saved Emmett Kilmer's life.
I literally would have died, and to this day, I'll never forget that.
It all happened when he and his friend took a break from studying.
Me and my buddy were studying for finals. You want to take a break? I really wanted to jump the stair set. It was about like 8 stairs.
Emmett says this involves jumping down the stairs on a skateboard or snowboard.
You're here and you jump down like a set of stairs. What I was doing was just incredibly dumb.
He lost balance in the air and fell. Emmett wasn't wearing a helmet and his head hit the ground directly.
I remember waking up in an ambulance and just being in like the most pain of my life.
He was fortunate to have a friend with him who was able to get him help, and he ended up hospitalized in intensive care.
They put me in a medically induced coma, and I woke up 14 hours later.
Emmett suffered a serious concussion.
So a concussion is a traumatic event to the brain. It can be a direct blow, or it can be a result of somebody hitting you and you hitting your head, and sometimes it's a shaking of the head. The most common symptom is a headache, but there are other symptoms such as dizziness. People can be nauseous. They can feel kind of foggy.
Because of the injury, Emmett had to take a break from school and from the sports he loves.
I couldn't go like running. I couldn't do really big sports activities. I couldn't do homework for like 2 or 3 days. I had to miss my finals.
We sometimes will take them out of school. If they have a job that does a lot of computer work, we want them to limit that activity initially, depending on the severity of their concussion.
Having something like that happen to you in your life really makes you reevaluate everything that you do.
Emmett began working with Dr. Weber after he was released from the hospital. She says when it comes to recovering from a concussion, the most important thing is rest.
We rested him and allowed his brain to have the time it needed to recover. Typically, most people get over concussion 10 to 14 days. You know, the ones that are dragging out, taking, you know, 3, 4, 5, 6 months to get better, those are the more complicated concussions. There are those individuals that have multiple concussions that can have long-term deficits. They were just not back to their normal baseline.
Dr. Weber says while not all concussions are as severe as Emmett's, it's still important to get someone who may have one help.
They should be pulled from what they're doing. So our rule is if there's any thought that there's a concussion, they get pulled from their sport. If in doubt, they sit out. They should be observed. If you're not sure, take them in.
Emmett was on medication for weeks and was monitored closely. And slowly, he began to feel less foggy.
There was a period where like I was in a serious daze and I felt like I wasn't entirely there.
So it's a matter of, you know, working through the process of recovery, and then once he's recovered, getting him back to sports and to activity.
After several months, Emmett was able to get back on his skateboard and snowboard. He now encourages others to be safe in whatever sport they choose.
Since then, I never went out and rode my snowboard without a helmet. That's probably the first thing I'd say, like, please just go put on a helmet. I actually would have been fine probably if I had a helmet.
This is really a serious issue. The brain needs time to recover, and I think that when you're helping somebody with a concussion or you're around people that have concussions, you want to be as supportive as you can.